Alright, this is my Artattack Nitro RC snowmobile. Just finished getting it together. Got it off eBay with this custom painted hood. Looks alright. Might change it up eventually, but for now it's good enough. I got it running with a OS21VG engine and a Jammin' JP1 pipe. I had modified the header on the pipe to accommodate the snowmobile. It used to be a 180 degree pipe, now it's a 90 degree pipe. I made this steel wire framing that I painted red to stiffen up the chassis, because the factory setup, they're kind of flimsy. So I connected to the upper shock towers, then down low at a mounting spot, and then back here at the tunnel. On the back of that framing, I put a threaded turnbuckle so that it can be lengthened to actually flex the chassis a little more to tension up the belt. Works out pretty well. And that belt is actually a longer belt. This is the factory belt. It's a 110 tooth belt, where now I have a 120 tooth belt on there, because I wanted to put a Traxxas Easy Start on this engine, so I had to slide the engine forward, so I needed a longer belt. To slide the engine forward, I have it mounted on an 1/8 inch aluminum plate, and then the 1/8 inch plate is then mounted to the chassis where the engine would be. To mount that Easy Start onto this motor, I had to make a spacer. You can see right here, it's a 1/4 inch aluminum spacer, so that the one-way bearing inside the Easy Start would clear the back of the motor. The bolt pattern and everything else worked out perfect for from the Easy Start to the OS engine. I wanted to be able to start this motor from my remote with my third channel, so to do that, under the seat, I took the Easy Start hand wand, and I took it apart, and hardwired the starting motor and a glow plug to it, took out the push button, and put in some jumper wires. And those are linked with a Turnigy RC switch to a 12-volt auto relay. So the RC switch will turn on the auto relay, and the relay will turn on the Easy Start hand wand, and then that'll start up the motor. All works out pretty good. Up here in this space, I put a 7.4-volt LiPo battery, and that's what powers the radio and the starter off the same battery pack. So we get some snow, I can get out there and give it a try.